This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Richard Nixon, Republican elected President Richard Nixon, Republican Watergate scandal, Watergate complex events list timeline, Nixon White House tapes, Operation Sandwedge, Operation Gemstone, 1972 U.S. presidential election, presidency of Richard Nixon, Saturday Night Massacre, White House horrors, United States v. Nixon, resignation speech, inauguration of Gerald Ford, people, Watergate burglars, Bernard Barker, Virgilio Gonzalez, Eugenio Martinez, James W. McCord Jr., Frank Sturgis groups, master list of Nixon's political opponents, Nixon's enemies list, Watergate babies, Watergate 7, White House plumbers, CRP committee for the re-election of the president, CRP Fred LaRue, Jeb Stuart Magruder, Robert Mardian, John N. Mitchell, Kenneth Parkinson, Hugh W. Sloan Jr., Maurice Stans, White House President Richard Nixon, Alexander Butterfield, Charles Colson, John Dean, John Ehrlichman, Gerald Ford, H.R. Haldeman, E. Howard Hunt, Eagle Krog, G. Gordon Liddy, Gordon C. Strawn, Rose Mary Woods, Judiciary, Archibald Cox, Leon Jaworski, John Sirica, Journalists, Carl Bernstein, Bob Woodward, Ben Bradley, Howard Simons, The Washington Post Intelligence Community, Mark Felt, Deep Throat, L. Patrick Gray, Richard Helms, James R. Schlesinger, Congress, Howard Baker, Sam Ervin, Peter W. Rodino, U.S. Senate Watergate Committee related, Frank Wills, Security Guard, James F. Neal, Prosecutor, All the President's Men book, film, The Final Days book, film, Dick film, V.E. The United States presidential election of 1972 was the 47th quadrennial presidential election, held on Tuesday, November 7, 1972. The Democratic Party's nomination was eventually won by Senator George McGovern of South Dakota, who ran an anti-war campaign against incumbent Republican President Richard Nixon, but was handicapped by his outsider status, limited support from his own party, the perception of many voters that he was a left-wing extremist, and the scandal that resulted from the stepping down of vice presidential nominee Thomas Eagleton. Emphasizing a good economy and his successes in foreign affairs, such as coming near to ending American involvement in the Vietnam War and establishing relations with China, Nixon won the election in a landslide overall. Nixon won 607% of the popular vote, a percentage only slightly lower than Lyndon B. Johnson in 1964, but with a larger margin of victory in the popular vote, 232%, the fourth largest in presidential election history. He received almost 18. Furthermore, the presidential term of 1973 to 1977 is notable for being the only one in American history in which both the original president and vice president failed to complete the term. Vice President Spiro Agnew, who resigned less than a year after the election over allegations that he had accepted bribes as governor of Maryland, was replaced by Gerald Ford under the terms of the 25th Amendment, while Nixon would resign due to the Watergate scandal in August 1974. Ultimately, the term of 1973 to 77 would see two different presidents and three different vice presidents. Contents: 1. Democratic nomination, 11 candidates. Gallery: 12 primaries, 13 primary results, 14 notable endorsements, 15 1972 Democratic National Convention, 16 the vice presidential vote, 2 Republican nomination, 21 candidates. Gallery: 22 primaries, 23 primary results, 24 convention, 3 third parties, 4 general election, 41 campaign, 42 results, 421 results by state, 43 close states, 5 scandals, 51 Watergate, 52 corporate campaign contributions, 6 see also, 7 references, 8 bibliography and further reading, 9 external links. Democratic nomination main article, Democratic Party presidential primaries, 1972 overall, 15. Were, George McGovern, Senator from South Dakota, Hubert Humphrey, Senator from Minnesota and former Vice President, Presidential nominee in 1968, George Wallace, Governor of Alabama, Edmund Muskie, Senator from Maine, Vice Presidential nominee in 1968, Eugene J. McCarthy, former Senator from Minnesota, Henry M. Jackson, Senator from Washington, Shirley Chisholm, Representative of New York's 12th Congressional District, Terry Sanford, former Governor of North Carolina, John Lindsay, Mayor of New York City, New York, Wilbur Mills, Representative of Arkansas's 2nd Congressional District, Vance Hartke, Senator from Indiana, Fred Harris, Senator from Oklahoma, Sam Yorty, Mayor of Los Angeles, California, Patsy Mink, Representative of Hawaii's 2nd Congressional District, Walter Fontroy, Delegate from Washington, D.C. Candidates Gallery. Senator George McGovern from South Dakota, Senator and former Vice President Hubert Humphrey from Minnesota, Governor George Wallace of Alabama, Senator Edmund Muskie from Maine ended primary campaign April 28, Senator Henry M. Jackson from Washington ended primary campaign May 2, Representative Shirley Chisholm from New York, former Governor Terry Sanford of North Carolina, Representative Wilbur Mills from Arkansas, Senator Vance Hartke from Indiana withdrew March 26, endorsed Humphrey, New York City Mayor John Lindsay withdrew April 4, former Senator Eugene McCarthy from Minnesota withdrew May 22, endorsed McGovern, Representative Patsy Mink from Hawaii withdrew May 24, Los Angeles Mayor Sam Yorty withdrew June, endorsed Humphrey, Senator Fred Harris from Oklahoma withdrew November 10, 71. Delegate Walter Fontroy from Washington, D.C. withdrew May 2, 1972 primaries. See also, George McGovern presidential campaign, 1972 Senate Majority Whip Ted Kennedy, the youngest brother of late President John F. Kennedy and late United States Senator Robert F. Kennedy, was the favorite to win the 1972. Reported that Muskie broke down and cried, shattering the candidate's image as calm and reasoned nearly 2 years before the election. South Dakota Senator George McGovern entered the race as an anti-war, progressive candidate. McGovern was able to pull together support from the anti-war movement and other grassroots support to win the nomination in a primary system he had played a significant part in designing on January 25, 1972. New York Representative Shirley Chisholm announced she would run, and became the first African-American woman to run for the Democratic or Republican presidential nomination. Hawaii Representative Patsy Mink also announced she would run and became the first Asian American to run for the Democratic presidential nomination on April 25. George McGovern won the Massachusetts primary 2 days later. Journalist Robert Novak quoted a Democratic senator, later revealed to be Thomas Eagleton, as saying, "The people don't know McGovern is for amnesty, abortion, and legalization of pot once Middle America, Catholic Middle America, in particular, finds this out, he's dead." The label stuck and McGovern became known as the candidate of amnesty, abortion, and acid. It became Humphrey's battle cry to stop McGovern, especially in the Nebraska primary. Alabama Governor George Wallace, an anti-integrationist, did well in the South. He won every county in the Florida primary and in the North among alienated and dissatisfied voters. Citation. Needed, what might have become a forceful campaign was cut short when Wallace was shot in an assassination attempt by Arthur Bremer on May 15. Wallace was struck by 5 bullets and left paralyzed from the waist down. The day after the assassination attempt, Wallace won the Michigan and Maryland primaries, but the shooting effectively ended his campaign and he pulled out in July. In the end, McGovern won the nomination by winning primaries through grassroots support in spite of establishment opposition. McGovern had led a commission to redesign the Democratic nomination system after the divisive nomination struggle and convention of 1968. The fundamental principle of the McGovern Commission, that the Democratic primaries should determine the winner of the Democratic nomination, have lasted throughout every subsequent nomination contest. However, the new rules angered many prominent Democrats whose influence was marginalized, and those politicians refused to support McGovern's campaign, some even supporting Nixon instead, leaving the McGovern campaign at a significant disadvantage in funding compared to Nixon primary results. Statewide contest by winner primaries. Popular vote results: Hubert Humphrey 4,121,372 2,577%. George McGovern 4,053,451 2,534%. George Wallace 3,755,424 2,348%. Edmund Muskie 1,840,217 1,151%. Eugene McCarthy 553,990 346%. Henry M. Jackson 505,198 316%. Shirley Chisholm 430,703 269%. Terry Sanford 331,415 207%. John Lindsay 196,406 123%. Samuel Yorty 79,446 050%. Wilbur Mills 37,401 023%. Walter E. Fontroy 21,217 013%. Unpledged 19,400 16,533.012%, Ted Kennedy 16,693.010%, Vance Hartke 11,798.007%, Patsy Mink 8,286.005%, Nunn 6,269.004%. Notable endorsements: Edmund Muskie, former Governor of and Secretary of Commerce W. Averill Harriman from New York, Senator Harold Hughes from Iowa, Senator Birch Bayh from Indiana, Senator Adlai Stevenson III from Illinois, Senator Mike Gravel of Alaska, former Senator Stephen M. Young from Ohio, Governor Milton Schaap of Pennsylvania, former Governor Michael DeSalle of Ohio, Ohio State Treasurer Gertrude W. Donahue, astronaut John Glenn from Ohio, Hubert Humphrey, Mayor Jack Sensenbrenner of Columbus, Ohio, George McGovern, Senator Frank Church from Idaho, Senator John V. Tunney from California, George Wallace, former Governor Lester Maddox of Georgia, Shirley Chisholm, Representative Ron Dellums from California, feminist leader and author Betty Friedan, Reverend Jesse Jackson from Illinois, feminist leader, journalist, and DNC official Gloria Steinem, Terry Sanford, former President Lyndon B. Johnson from Texas, Henry M. Jackson, Governor Jimmy Carter of Georgia, 1972 Democratic National Convention Play Media Video from the Florida Convention's main article, 1972 Democratic National Convention Results, George McGovern 186,495 Henry M. Jackson 525 George Wallace 3817 Shirley Chisholm 15195 Terry Sanford 775 Hubert Humphrey 667 Wilbur Mills 338 Edmund Muskie 243 Ted Kennedy 127 Sam Yorty 10 Wayne Hayes 5 John Lindsay 5 Fred Harris 2 Eugene McCarthy 2 Walter Mondale 2 Ramsey Clark 1 Walter Fauntroy 1 Vance Hartke 1 Harold Hughes 1 Patsy Mink 1 The vice presidential vote with hundreds of delegates displeased with McGovern, the vote was chaotic, with at least three other candidates having their names put into nomination and votes scattered over 70 candidates. The eventual winner was Senator Thomas Eagleton from Missouri. The vice presidential balloting went on so long that McGovern and Eagleton were forced to begin making their acceptance speeches at around 2 a.m. local time after the convention ended. It was discovered that Eagleton had undergone psychiatric electroshock therapy for depression and had concealed this information from McGovern. A Time magazine poll taken at the time found that 77% of the respondents said Eagleton's medical record would not affect their vote. Nonetheless, the press made frequent references to his shock therapy, and McGovern feared that this would detract from his campaign platform. McGovern subsequently consulted confidentially with preeminent psychiatrists, including Eagleton's own doctors, who advised him that a recurrence of Eagleton's depression was possible and could endanger the country should Eagleton become president. McGovern had initially claimed that he would back Eagleton 1,000%, only to ask Eagleton to withdraw 3 days later. This perceived lack of conviction in sticking with his running mate was disastrous for the McGovern campaign. McGovern later approached six different prominent Democrats to run for vice president: Ted Kennedy, Edmund Muskie, Hubert Humphrey, Abraham Ribicoff, Larry O'Brien, and Rubin Askew. All six declined. Sergeant Shriver, brother-in-law to John, Robert, and Ted Kennedy, former ambassador to France and former director of the Peace Corps, later accepted. He was officially nominated by a special session of the Democratic National Committee. By this time, McGovern's poll ratings had plunged from 41% to 24%. Republican nomination. Republican candidates: Richard Nixon, President of the United States; Pete McCloskey, Representative from California; John M. Ashbrook, Representative from Ohio. Candidates gallery: President Richard Nixon, Representative John Ashbrook from Ohio, Representative Pete McCloskey from California. Primaries: Richard Nixon was a popular incumbent president in 1972, as he was credited with achieving détente with the People's Republic of China and the Soviet Union. Polls showed that Nixon held a strong lead in the Republican primaries. He was challenged by two candidates, liberal Pete McCloskey from California and conservative John Ashbrook from Ohio. McCloskey ran as an anti-war candidate, while Ashbrook opposed Nixon's détente policies towards China and the Soviet Union. In the New Hampshire primary, McCloskey garnered 198% of the vote to Nixon's 676%, with Ashbrook receiving 97%. President Nixon won 1323 of the 1324 delegates to the Republican Convention, with McCloskey receiving the vote of one delegate from New Mexico. Vice President Spiro Agnew was re-nominated by acclamation, while both the party's moderate wing and Nixon himself had wanted to replace him with a new running mate, the moderates favoring Nelson Rockefeller, and Nixon favoring John Connally. It was ultimately concluded that the loss of Agnew's base of conservative supporters would be too big of a risk. Primary results. Primary's popular vote result: Richard Nixon 5,378,704, 8,692%, unpledged 317,048, 512%, John Ashbrook 311,543, 503%, Pete McCloskey 132,731, 215%. Convention. Seven members of Vietnam Veterans Against the War were brought on federal charges for conspiring to disrupt the Republican Convention. They were acquitted by a federal jury in Gainesville, Florida. Third parties. The only major third-party candidate in the 1972 election was conservative Republican Representative John G. Schmitz, who ran on the American Party ticket, the party on whose ballot George Wallace ran in 1968. He was on the ballot in 32 states and received 1,099,482 votes. Unlike Wallace, however, he did not win a majority of votes cast in any state, and received no electoral votes. John Hospers of the newly formed Libertarian Party was on the ballot only in Colorado and Washington and received 3,573 votes, winning no states. However, he did receive one electoral vote from Virginia from a Republican faithless elector. See below. The Libertarian vice presidential nominee Theodora Tony Nathan became the first woman in U.S. history to receive an electoral vote. Linda Jenness was nominated by the Socialist Workers' Party, with Andrew Pulley as her running mate. Benjamin Spock and Julius Hobson were nominated for president and vice president, respectively, by the People's Party general election. Campaign. Richard Nixon during an August 1972 campaign stop. George McGovern speaking at an October 1972 campaign rally. McGovern ran on a platform of immediately ending the Vietnam War and instituting guaranteed minimum incomes for the nation's poor. His campaign was harmed by his views during the primaries, which alienated many powerful Democrats, the perception that his foreign policy was too extreme, and the Eagleton debacle with McGovern's campaign weakened by these factors. The Republicans successfully portrayed him as a radical left-wing extremist incompetent to serve as president. Nixon led in the polls by large margins throughout the entire campaign with an enormous fundraising advantage and a comfortable lead in the polls. Nixon concentrated on large rallies and focused speeches to closed, select audiences, leaving much of the retail campaigning to surrogates like Vice President Agnew. Nixon did not, by design, try to extend his coattails to Republican congressional or gubernatorial candidates, preferring to pad his own margin of victory. Results. Election results by county. 1972 presidential election, results by congressional district. Nixon's percentage of the popular vote was only nearly less than Lyndon Johnson's record in the 1964 election, and his margin of victory was slightly larger. Nixon won a majority vote in 49 states, including McGovern's home state of South Dakota. Only Massachusetts and the District of Columbia voted for the challenger, resulting in an even more lopsided Electoral College tally. It was the first election since 1808 in which New York did not have the largest number of electors in the Electoral College, having fallen to 41 electors versus California's 45. Although the McGovern campaign believed that its candidate had a better chance of defeating Nixon because of the new 26th Amendment to the United States Constitution that lowered the national voting age to 18 from 21, the plan backfired when most of the youth vote went to Nixon. This was the first election in American history in which a Republican candidate carried every single Southern state, continuing the region's transformation from a Democratic bastion into a Republican one, as Arkansas was carried by a Republican presidential candidate for the first time in history. By this time, all the Southern states, except Arkansas and Texas, had been carried by a Republican in either the previous election or the one in 1964. As a result of this election, Massachusetts was the only state that Nixon did not carry in any of his three presidential campaigns as of 2016. This was also the last election where Minnesota was carried by the Republican candidate. Minnesota was later the only state not won by Ronald Reagan in Either 1980 or 1984 in 22 states, McGovern failed to carry a single county. He carried a mere one or two counties in a further 14 states. In contrast to Walter Mondale's narrow 1984 win in Minnesota, he comfortably did win Massachusetts, but lost every other state by no less than 5 percentage points as well as 45 states by more than 10 percentage points, the exceptions being Massachusetts, Minnesota, Rhode Island, Wisconsin, and his home state of South Dakota. This election also made Nixon the second former vice president in American history to serve two terms back-to-back, after Thomas Jefferson in 1800 and 1804. Since McGovern carried only one state, bumper stickers reading "Nixon 49 America 1, Don't Blame Me I'm from Massachusetts" and "Massachusetts, the one and only" were popular for a short time in Massachusetts. Nixon managed to win 18% of the African American vote despite his Southern strategy presidential candidate party home state popular vote electoral vote running mate count. PCT vice presidential candidate home state elect vote Richard Milhouse Nixon incumbent Republican California 47,168,710 6,067% 520 Spiro Theodore Agnew Maryland 520 George Stanley McGovern Democratic South Dakota 29,173,222 3,752% 17 Robert Sargent Shriver Maryland 17 John G. Schmitz American Independent California 1,100,868 142% 0 Thomas J. Anderson Tennessee 0 Linda Jenis Socialist Workers Georgia 83,380 B011% 0 Andrew Pulley Illinois 0 Benjamin Spock Peoples California 78,759 010% 0 Julius Hobson District of Columbia 0 Louis Fisher Socialist Labor Illinois 53,814 007% 0 Genevieve Gunderson Minnesota 0 Gus Hall Communist New York 25,597 003% 0 Jarvis Tyner Pennsylvania 0 Evelyn Reed Socialist Workers New York 13,878 002% 0 Clifton DeBerry Illinois 0 E. Harold Munn Prohibition Michigan 13,497 002% 0 Marshall Uncaffer Kansas 0 John G. Hospers Libertarian California 3,674 000% 1 A. Theodora Nathan Oregon 1 A. Other 28,628 004% Other, total 77,744,027 100% 538,538 needed to win 270,270. Source Popular Vote, Lape, David 1972 Presidential Election Results Dave Lape's Atlas of U.S. Presidential Elections Retrieved August 7, 2005. McGovern 019% results by county, shaded according to winning candidates' percentage of the vote results by state states, districts won by Nixon, Agnew states, districts won by McGovern, Shriver Richard Nixon Republican George McGovern Democratic John Schmitz American Independent John Hospers Libertarian margin state total state electoral votes. Hash. Hashtag Alabama 9,728,701 7,243 9,256,923 2,554. Al-Alaska 355,349 5,813 330 2,967 3,462. AK Arizona 6 402,812 6,164 6 198,540 3,038